A very warm afternoon to all the students, faculty members, and respected members of the management. I heartily welcome you all to the distinguished lecture series hosted by Asian Business School. This is one of a kind initiative where we try to bridge the gap between students and industry and give a chance to our prodigies to interact with experts from the industry and understand their placement journeys better. Today, we have amongst us a very special guest, Mr. Debarga Deb, a general regional manager, HR North, who shall share his insights on how to craft your professional career. Mr. Deb is an HR professional with 16 plus years of multi-state experience as generalist HR, partnering business and managing HR relations with vast and remote employee base is one of his core competencies. Currently, he is heading HR functions of Dabur India Limited, North Region. He has a HR functional background of industries like FMCG, insurance, data processing centers, KPOs, etc. He has previously worked with other reputed companies such as Bharti AXA, General Insurance, HSBC, Electronic Data Processing, etc. And today he is here to share with you his valued experience and knowledge and share with you all certain tips which surely can help you climb up the corporate ladder. We welcome you, sir, to Asian Business School and would request you to kindly take the session forward.
Thank you, Pratita Garima. Thank you very much. Thank you to all the faculty members. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Thank you to all the students and the faculties to have me around here. It is always a great feeling to be amongst you, but definitely not the way we are connecting nowadays over online and this virtual mode. It gives me a good feeling and a good vibe when we are in campus, because to me, the campuses that we connect with are the future talent pools that we have, right? And if we are able to know them personally, if we are able to know them in their environment, that is always easier for us to understand the capability and the credibility of the students. And for me, these are the future talents. And crafting, helping you to craft your career would be a great opportunity for me, because if you craft your career well, me as an HR part of the organization will be benefited, right? So it is always a mutually beneficial relationship. So I have a small PPT with me, but I would not, the PPT would be just as a reference slide for you all. You can read through, you can ponder on that, because this is say half an hour, 45 minutes of a session. I'm sure you will not be able to craft your career just after this. You go back and you are able to craft your career. We all have to think. So what I'll provide you today is a pointers. What I'll provide you is some triggers to think. And based on those thoughts, based on those triggers, you can now think over. You are just at the first year, right? At the first year, second year of your MBA. So think, understand, and then implement if you like the ideas. And then let's see where it takes us, right? We are all crafting our careers. Crafting the career is not a time-bound activity. You have to keep on reinventing yourself. You have to keep on recrafting yourself as per the requirement of the time. So it never stops. So you don't think that it will stop after 2 years of your college or since class 10th or 11th, we keep on thinking when the exam will be over and when I'll start the job. But when you start the job, you realize that you have to give more efforts. In your college days, here you still have a routine. You still know the syllabus. You still know what is going to happen in the next class or what is going to happen in the next assignment. But in office, it is always a surprise. You plan a day, you write down your things that you would like to do all this, but suddenly you realize that your boss calls up and gives you a different presentation to work on, and you leave everything and you start doing. I'm sure our faculty members have gone through this. We as a corporate do go through this every day. So this readiness is important, and this readiness only will come from your ability to quickly craft and recraft yourself, right? So having said that, let me share my screen. This is just for a reference again. We'll not bore you with the presentation as such, but let's see, the ideas will be useful to you, I suppose. Right, I hope my screen is visible to all of you. Right, great. So before crafting something, I'm sure you have seen a lot of DIY videos in YouTube, you have seen people creating a lot of crafts, you have seen people, the potters making potteries and all that, people weaving and making nice dress materials out of it. So all these craftings, so there are always two types of crafts, you see. There is one thing which is locally made, one thing you go to a local shop and purchase, and one thing you go to a branded shop and purchase, right? The pricing always gets different. Maybe the product is same. Maybe the source is also the same. So what makes the difference? I'm sure you all are agreeing to the fact that the difference is the brand, right? So the same quality, same thing, we are allowed towards a brand to go and buy that, thinking that it will be better quality, it will keep the promises that is being made, and it will match my personality, right? So the brand is what makes a difference. I know, and I totally agree to the fact that there are opportunities, there are ways that you can also go to a local way of dealing with things and go and make purchases there. But tentatively, we all turn towards a brand. Now, if you move that idea from a product to a person, that is about yourself, then how do you think the brand would be important? So if you have to craft your career, you have to first of all brand yourself. You have to be somebody among many people, right? We are now a homogeneous community, right? You go to your MBA college and see there are out of today, we are having around 70, 80 students who are participating here. The college has got maybe around 200 students in total. Out of 200 students, you will see 100% of the people have gone through a 10 plus 2 plus 3 plus years of education. Around 99% of the people know at least 3 languages. Most of them are from an urban town. Most of them have a vehicle and a dish TV and a smart TV and a smartphone at their places, multiple in number maybe. So the differentiator. So when I as a recruiter go to a campus, how do I differentiate among all of you? Language skills, same. Education, same. Demography, mostly same. Age, mostly same. The kind of parental background, mostly same. Kind of cities you're coming from, mostly same. Then how do I differentiate? What is marks? Mostly, all the more, mostly same only. So how would I differentiate as a person, as a recruiter, that okay, this 4 or 5 people are good for my organization and my culture, and rest would be for somewhere else. So this is something which is very, very important to be thought about. And that this differentiating factor is a personal branding. So this is why you should create your brand. Not only create, you should build up on your brand. I have a formula called spice. You should spice up your brand at a time to time. And important is maintain the brand. Right? So if you like Maggie as a brand, and if it suddenly goes down the curve and you get to know that there are a lot of harmful things in Maggie, will you still have that love for Maggie? You might want to change to something else. So building the brand, creating the brand, building the brand, making it spicier, and maintaining the brand, all are important, right? So moving on, what is your personal brand? So is it the way you look, the way you dress, the way you the way you talk, or the community you belong to, or maybe the position you hold? Is it the designation is your brand, or is it achievement, like a lot of trophies around you? Is it your brand? I don't think so. I really don't think, because these things can all be common again. The way you look, there is somebody else also who can dress up like you, who can look as sharper as you. Community, nowadays it doesn't matter anymore. Position you hold, it's just a designation. Today you hold a position, tomorrow you don't. Your achievements, that's always your past, not your future. So how do you define your personal brand? to me, and there's again, this is a thought that I'm sharing. I am requesting all the students to think about it and then ponder on that. To me, the brand is what people say about you. It is very important. You are there in a group, you are there in a community. Think about that you are there, you are in a student community. So what does your peer think about you? What does your teachers think about you? What they say about you? What I say, that I am very punctual, I am very honest, I am very, so imagine a day where I as a recruiter would come to your campus and ask your fellow student that, okay, introduce your fellow colleague and tell me three good points about him. And if your fellow student is not able to say, that means you have not created your brand. That does not mean he is not your good friend. It means that you have not created your brand. So what people say about you is important, right? If I have a doubt of among three people, I like both of them, where do I go to? I go to maybe Professor Garima and ask, hey, Professor Garima, who among these two is better? If you have not built your brand, how would Professor Garima tell me that, okay, this person has got this skills, this person has got this strength, now you choose. So it is about what people say about you. It is also about knowing your uniqueness. You have at least one, two, three things about you which is different from others. You have to discover it. You are in the first year, second year of your career. You're just building your career. MBA is just the gateway of your career. Do not think that it is too late. And do not think that I am very average, I am very common, I do not have a uniqueness. All of us do have something or the other. When I give you examples, you will realize. So find and discover your uniqueness. Build on that. Build stories on that. What strength that uniqueness has given you. What success that uniqueness has given you. That is very important. Discovering your strength. That is important. You have to discover what your strength is. And then you are the only differentiator. So you are the only differentiator from you. So there is nothing else which will differentiate you. The way you look, the community, your position, achievements, nothing else. The only differentiator is you, right? I'm holding to this slide. Think over. If you want to take a screenshot, take a screenshot. But think over these four things. How would you build your, what people say about you? What is your uniqueness? Discovering your strength. And then only you will become a differentiator. As I told you, today is a surplus society. We have surplus of manpower, similar companies, employing similar people with similar education background, similar job background, coming with similar ideas, product producing similar things, similar price, similar quality. How do you differentiate? It is a challenge. Today's date, it is a big time challenge. So if you have HUL, Dabur, Imami, Reckitt, ITC, Godrej, all this company coming to you, every company has to fight for its own brand in your mind. And we have to fight to become a differentiator. I cannot say that Dabur is best. ITC is there, HUL is there, Reckitt is there, Godrej is there, everybody is there, Marico is there, Colgate is there. How do I as a company differentiate myself in your mind? And then only you will choose me. So recruitment in a campus is a choice. I would choose you, you would choose me, right? So how would that choice happen if I'm not able to differentiate? And that differentiator can only be through the brand, right? So branding yourself, how would you brand yourself? It is, first of all, you do have to believe yourself. You have to believe that you have some uniqueness. You have to believe that the way you are, you have to accept yourself. So believing in yourself, if you do not believe in yourself, then who else will believe? If you do not, nobody else will, right? You are one of the best fakes of yourself. That's what is being told. So believing in yourself, uniqueness. So maybe we look forward to a skill which is called sense of responsibility. Now, if I go and ask a student that, okay, how do you know that? How do I know that you have a sense of responsibility in you? Somebody tells me that they have done campus activity, they have been a part of placement committee, they have been part of this, that. But you know, those who have maybe a younger brother or sister, and you have been an elder brother and sister, and you have taken care of your younger sibling throughout your lifetime while your parents are working, you have helped them out in their craft, you have helped them out in their homework, you have helped them out with their fooding, clothing. That's sense of responsibility, my dear. And that is something which you have been doing lifelong. We don't treat those things as a skill. we ignore things which we do very commonly, right? So if you are a good organizer of your family picnics, you've been a good organizer of your family shadis and sangeets and birthdays, you have a good ability to show teamwork. So think, look at your life, look at the past activities that you have done and convert that into organizational skills. Arranging a picnic seemed to be nothing during your childhood days. But now, if you change that into ability to organize things, organizational skills, that becomes an important skill for a corporate. Sense of responsibility, taking care of siblings, being a captain of a cricket football team, that means result oriented. You are a captain, and if you fail continuously, will you remain a captain? No. So you become a result-oriented person through a sports leadership. So things you have been doing throughout your life have got a lot of skills in you. And that is something which is important. So that brings me to my next point, which is discovering yourself. We all think that MBA mein abhi start kiya, abhi mera jaake experience banega. Yaar, MBA se pehle, we have around 10 to 12 years, 15 years of my life, adulthood. Say maybe from your 10th onwards till MBA, around 5-6 years have gone by. That is the adulthood you have lived. And you have had your experiences there. Take out your life experiences and discover yourself. Right? So there are 5 things which always you should look for. One is called yearning. This is a technology I'm telling you. So as I told you, these are thoughts which I'm sharing. You need to follow and find out whether you are interested in doing that. I am leading you with some with some techniques also. Technique one is yearning. Yearning is what? Yearning is there are certain things which you like doing by yourself, and there are certain things which you don't like. There are people who likes cooking. There are people who likes to travel. There are people who likes to mingle with people, and there are people who don't like to mingle with people or would like to sit down at a corner and read a book. So things which you yearn for. Yearn means जो आपके अंदर से आता है, things which you feel to do, that is something please demarcate, understand, list it down, right? That those are the things which you can easily do. You do not have to do any hard work for it. You have been doing it for your lifetime. If you are doing it for your lifetime, understand the skill behind it. Things which you have been always doing, understand the skill behind that. Number one. Number two, rapid learning. There are a lot of subjects you will see in your school. There are few subjects which you can easily learn. And there are few subjects which is very difficult for you. You have to take assistance. That is called rapid learning. Somebody can learn numerical things very quickly. Somebody can learn textual thing very quickly. Somebody can learn through pictorial way very quickly. Somebody can learn by listening to people very quickly. So how would you learn? What is your process of learning? You have already learned for last, God knows, 15 years. Right, 10 plus 2 plus 3, 15 years you have learned. So think, how have you learned? Which are the areas which is your easy learning? Which are the ways you have learned difficulty? So those are your easy learning ways. Make things easier for you. Life is not complicated. Life is easy. It's about a choice. So you choose the easier path. You choose the right formula to that and follow that. It not always be a struggle. So rapid learning. Think about things which you can easily learn. Next point is flow. Flow is something which you can easily do. Flow is something which comes to you naturally, right? There are, you will see people who would, if you are sitting in a group of 5-6 people, there would be one person who will stand up and start getting organizing things. Achha, chalo, speaker kaha hai, achha, Bluetooth kaha hai, playlist bana lete, gana chalate hai, raat ko snacks mein kya hai, which movie to watch. Somebody, one or two people will take a lead and keep on arranging those things. So that person is a good organizer. So that's a natural flow for it. There would be another person who would be at the end of the get together, will be always there with the breakup of the cost. Achha, total itna kharcha hua tha, sab mein baatna hai, to dutch karna hai, to this is the costing. So that comes naturally. Nobody told him to do it, but he is doing it naturally. So he's good with numericals, maybe he is good with data, right? So think about what are the natural flow with you. That's the third point. Fourth important point is glimpses of excellence. It's been 15 years till now that you have been studying, you have been going to school, you have been meeting people in the community, and you have been competing in the real world. Do not think that job se mera naukri shuru hota hai, job se mera experience shuru hota hai. 15 saal ka isse pehle bhi experience hai. And that is something which is very, very important. During those experiences, where all have you excelled? Where all have you done well? Remember those, be proud of those, and try to repeat those things which you have done. That is called glimpses of excellence. Aapke purane experiences ko excellence ko yaad kijiye and accordingly react and act to it. And last and important thing is satisfaction. Things which gives you satisfaction. Discover yourself is that. Earning, yearning, learning, flow, glimpse of excellence, satisfaction. Again, leaving you with the thought, think over this, find out your points on this, and then list it down. Right? There is a saying that find a job you love and you'll never have to work in the day of your life. So if you like doing your job, if you love your job, you'll not feel that I'm going to work. You'll be thinking that it's a passion for me which I'm following. So find a job you love. But again, we'll have questions that, okay, why in this time, how do we get a job which we love? There are problems, there are pandemic and all these things. But believe me, maybe not immediately, but in due course of time, you will. Right? Reinvent yourself. So what we spoke about here, inventing yourself. But as I told you, branding, crafting is not a one-time job. You have to reinventing yourself. So reinvent yourself. There's a comfort zone and there's a courage zone. Courage zone means you move towards a higher duty. Push yourself for a higher duty. Push yourself for adventure. Push yourself for bravery. Things push yourself to overcome things that you are afraid of. Risk. Take risk. Difficult things. Opportunity. These are courage zone. Comfort zone. Courage zone. Keep on revisiting every 3 years. Very important. You push yourself to higher duties and adventures and all that. And then you realize that that becomes your comfort zone. In 3 years, again, you change to something else. So that is important, right? So pushing yourself, reinventing yourself is important. I hope I am aligned. Professor Garima, any questions, anything that is coming from the students? Is it in line with the discussion?
Yes, sir. Students are sending questions. We've got a couple of questions. Shall we take the questions right now or should we?
We'll wrap it up in another 10 minutes and then yes, we can sir. Start taking the questions.
Sure.
Okay. So as I told you, renewing yourself is important. Continuous learning, refreshments, it's a key to cutting edge. So you have to remain at the edge. You cannot remain at the back foot and say that my career is not taking a flight. You have to be at the edge. लोग जब skydiving करते हैं edge से छलांग मारते हैं ना लोग जब glider में चढ़ते हैं edge से आगे air पकड़ते हैं ना so you have to be on the edge if you have to take a flight. That is very important. Be yourself because everybody else is taken. You cannot be somebody else. Everybody else has a different personality. You have to create your own personality and be yourself. God has made each one of us first class original. Do not spend your life to become a second class copy. These are quotations, but remember, this will help. And last important formula that I always believe in, you have to invest and spice it up. You have to invest in yourself. You spending money in an MBA college, spending money in a college is not enough. You have to invest on yourself spiritually. Spiritually, I do not mean religiously. I mean that inner consciousness, self-consciousness, awareness, self-awareness, spiritually. Physically, remaining fit, remaining agile, very important. Physically, intellectually, very important to have an intellectual bent of mind, very important to have a curious bent of mind. Spiritually, physically, intellectually, build your own community. Build your own people around you. And by community, I do not mean creed or caste. By community, I mean people of like-minded people, people who would like to exchange ideas and share ideas. Build your community and be emotionally active. Do not be a very passive person. People would like to see very passionate people around them, right? So spice is spiritually, invest yourself in a spice way. And spiritually, physically, intellectually, build your community and emotionally. So if you invest in spice, you will see that you are creating your brand slowly and steadily, right? So this is something which sums up. Happy branding for all of you. I would suggest think over this PPT, think over these thoughts, and then accordingly try and build. This is some nice opportunity which you will guys have, and build on that. That is most important. Happy branding to all of you. Thank you. And I'll be happy to take questions.
Thank you so much, sir. I think, well, this brief talk was very, very essential for our students because our listeners today have just completed their first year of their PGDM course and they are entering their second year. And most of them are very curious to know that how would the placements be, what should we do? And the very specific question which everyone has in their mind, every student, is that how should we crack it? And I think one answer which has very brightly come out of the presentation is, how are you different from the other person? That is exactly how you're going to crack for a company who is looking at you. And I think, sir, you would agree that students should probably start with a lot of self-awareness, who they are, what backgrounds do they have, what capacities do they hold, as you've rightly mentioned in your presentation as well. Isn't it? Do you believe that?
I believe so, because it is very important for them, for an interviewer, in that 15 minutes of interaction to see a personality. I do not want to see yet another candidate. I do not want to see yet another candidate with me that, okay, so this is A, B, C, D. I would like to see a personality there. And to tell me about the personality, the person has to somehow talk to me about things which are not there in the CV. Somehow has to talk to me about things I can see that he or she as a father, as a mother, as a brother, coming from a town in UP, in Bengal, in somewhere. But what is that giving back to him or her? What is that? How the parental thing has crafted his personality? That is what I would like to know more. So that is how you start your answer, and that is how you make me interested in the interview.
Right, sir. So we have a couple of questions here from the student side. The very first question, I'm sure you must be prepared for this. What skills does HR consider most while hiring a fresh talent?
HR, and let me tell you before the answer that it is not changing with pandemic. It is not changing with the years to come. There are few basic skills which an organization would need, few human and a personal skill which an organization will need ever, be it work from home, be it work from office, anywhere. So when I as an HR go to a campus, I would look at somebody who is good at learning. Learnability is very high, can give me examples of learning that he or she has done. So learnability, ability to adapt, so adaptability. Learnability, adaptability, and most importantly and most serious thing is that discipline or integrity. So that is something which is very important. I would look at least these three things to begin with. There are then other technical skills and a lot of things coming, but those things can be taught. If I get to know that a person is not good with Excel, I can teach them. If a person is not good with communication skills, we can be teaching them. The issue remains with that. Adaptability, learnability, and discipline. These are the three core skills, core personality skills which a person should come with.
Right. So I think this comes as a food for thought to our students that in all those behavioral questions on their introductions, these are the areas which one should be able to display on to the recruiter through their answers and attitude for most to be able to get selected. So the second question is that what method of self-exploration would you recommend for the students to go through before applying for a job or a specific company?
Self-exploration the person has to go through for a specific company is that try and understand the company culture. Very important. You have to know about the company culture. Try to go to LinkedIn, try to go to Glassdoor, try to read reviews of the people, try to understand what the company is all about, try to go to their Facebook page and understand, and then build your answers according to that culture. If an organization, like for example, Dabur, if an organization, Dabur is a very grass-rooted, Indianized company. And if I come across to the interviewer as somebody who is like very high-flying, very outspoken, very, very, very international kind of a profile, डाबर रिक्रूटर माइट फील ये तो मेरे देसी कंपनी में काम नहीं कर पाएगा, राइट? सो पर्सनालिटी ऑफ द कैंडिडेट हैज टू बी डिफाइंड, हैज टू बी प्रेजेंटेड अकॉर्डिंग टू द कल्चर. So if you are looking at a specific company, then first of all know the culture of the company, and of course about then the products and everything else is important.
Right. I think this is where some students really lack, that they don't undergo the background of the company and just understand.
So people do the research on when the company was formed. Believe me, I as a recruiter don't need to know that. I don't need to know who was my founder. I need to know whether you have connected and understood my company and tell me things which connects with my company.
Right. Sir, a student named Karan Dev has put across a question that, sir, we know that without entering into a particular field, we can't predict that it is good or bad for us. So my question is, if someone like two things that belong to do two different fields, then how to choose amongst them? Because we cannot choose to work in both these sectors together. Probably that is what the student wants to understand.
It is good to have options at the beginning of the career. It is good to have options that you might like two things, you might want to explore two things, and believe me, there is nothing that one thing is bad and another thing is good. One thing suits you, the other thing doesn't suit. It is like that. It suits somebody else. So there is nothing good or bad in a sector or a company or a job. It is just a matter of fact that whether it will suit you or it will not suit you. So for choosing that, you can always work in a place. See, gone are those days when we expected you join me and retire from me. You join me, work 1 year, 2 years, 6 months, see whether it suits you, then join somewhere else and see that whether that sector suits you. People will not judge you because of that. Itna jaldi jaldi aap log kyun naukri chhod rahe? Aajkal koi nahi puchta. First 2 to 3 years is the years of testing the waters. Do go ahead, test the water, check, and then decide.
Definitely. So I think experience is the key. Answer to the students. So has there been a shift in the professional culture due to the global pandemic, and do you think this will be changing the way people look at their professional journeys?
See, the culture has changed in a way that organizations' leaders have become more inclusive. That is very important. So the leadership has gone through a lot of change. They have become more inclusive. They are okay to these ideas of remote working.
Right.
They are okay to these ideas of not seeing the person and still trusting that he is working. Right. So the leadership thoughts have gone a lot of change than the ground level stuff. People have become more aware of their own responsibilities, and they are doing it their own selves. Policings have gone down. So these are the changes in the culture and the attitude of leaders that has happened over the years, and that's good for us.
Right, sir. Sir, a student wants to know that what has your journey been like in Dabur India Limited, one of the most iconic Indian companies?
My journey in Dabur is a brilliant, exciting journey. So I joined Dabur from a completely different industry. So my unique place is I have worked in HR for last 16 years, but none of the companies are same. So I started my career in an IT product company. Then I moved to a KPO in Hyderabad. Then I moved to insurance back in Kolkata. And then I moved to Dabur. So FMCG, insurance, IT. These are the mixed sectors that I work for. Mm-hmm. And as an HR, I am privileged to work very closely with the business. I know those businesses well. So my uniqueness is that I can, if somebody now asks me to consult for an FMCG company, I can go ahead and help him out to open a FMCG company, being only in HR. So I always say that understanding your business is very important. So my journey in Dabur is like that. I have been working with business very closely. I have worked throughout multiple zones. I work very closely with our head office. So from an execution point of view and from a strategic point of view, both experiences I have taken up here.
Great, sir. So as monetary rewards, are monetary rewards only the type of success a person should aim for in their career?
Definitely not. Monetary rewards are just one of the ways of getting rewarded. There are recognitions, there are promotions, there are learning opportunities, getting your company sponsoring you to do a MDP at IIM Ahmedabad or an XLRI is recognition enough. Even if it's not monetary, that it is not adding some money to my purse, but it is adding investing in my career, it is adding some armors to my kitty. So definitely monetary is just one way. There are lot many other ways of getting rewarded.
Right. So this question is from my end, sir, because a lot of students are seen in the past as well, in present as well, they have this dilemma. What should they opt for? Should they opt for a good brand and probably a smaller role? Should they sacrifice on the role, or should they go for the role, be it in a startup or in a smaller company and the brand name is not very good, but the role is very satisfactory? So what should a student go for at the very initial stage of their career?
I'll tell you, there is another angle to this. So there is a role, there is a thing called role, there is a thing called salary, there is a thing called stability of the career, and then there is also a thing called learning. So which organization or which role gives you a better learning is that what you choose for? If your learning is good, then in another 6 months, 1 year time, you can translate that learning into a better experience to a different company. But if your learning is not good, then you're not investing the right way. So it is very important that the role which gives you a good learning is the role you should go for.
Definitely. So a clear cut idea I think the students would have gotten here is that they should understand the job specifications and job descriptions well, that what is the role demanding, which is more important. Okay, sir, another question here from a student is, what are the common mistakes or errors potential candidates make while presenting themselves during the recruitment in major companies like yours?
See, one major mistake what a candidate does is showing the anxiousness for the job, right? However anxious we are, however worried we are, you should not show that anxiousness. Well, at the beginning of my presentation, I told that it's a mutually benefiting relation between a candidate and a recruiter. I am there to get people for my organization. I am not there to do charity, right? So I need to go back at the end of the day with some selected people. That is why I am investing the whole day in the campus. So it is my responsibility to choose the right person. And it is the candidate's responsibility to become that right person. And that candidate cannot show me the anxiousness to get a job, because that kind of tells me that the anxiousness translates into a desperation, and that kind of looks very odd from a candidate. That's number one mistake. Number two mistake is that the candidate does not appear to the recruiter as a personality. The candidate appears to the recruiter as one another candidate.
Right.
So it is very important that CV is just a tool in my hand to be very frank, I always tell CV is there just to distract me myself from looking at the candidate. If I'm not interested in him, I will look at his CV and pass my time. So I most of the time in the campuses, I say that I do not want to have a CV in my hand, because I will get distracted. If I'm bored, then I'm looking at something else. I have to know that I have to spend 10 minutes time with that candidate. I'm bored in first 3 minutes. Mm-hmm. So the candidate has to come out as a personality. They have to tell the story. So I give an example here, that Three Idiots, that interview board example, where he comes and tells the story that how, kaise uske haath pair toote hai, right? And that story sells for him. That story tells his characteristic. So every candidate should have, I'm not saying that every candidate should have broken hands and legs during interview, but every candidate should have a story to tell me. Every candidate should have a personality to create.
And I think they can speak of those stories and think of it when they actually analyze the experiences, as you mentioned, that they've taken in life. We really don't, introspect that much and take those things seriously. Like a very beautiful example you gave, if you're able to organize family functions or a smaller picnic, you've got a great skill set with you, which probably is demanded in the organizational world as well. Great. Sir, being an HR expert, what career advice would you like to offer to students aspiring for an HR career?
See, students for an HR career, I would always say that choose HR only when you are having a great sensitivity towards people. Because HR, whatever grade you join, people will expect you to be very responsible, very attentive, very responsive, very loyal, very comforting kind of a person. Right. Even if you are basically the taskmaster, you are basically the custodian of the rules, you follow all the rules, but be accessible to people. That is something very important. If you are a introvert and if you feel that, okay, main akela rehna pasand karta, then don't choose HR, because HR will be surrounded with people most of the time. Mm-hmm. So it is very important to be sensitive towards people. So that's one personality advice that I'm telling. Career advice wise, HR is a good opportunity. HR is a good role always. And during, we always, every 2-3 years you get to hear that HR automate ho jayega, robot aake kuch kar lega and everything. But there are core functions of HR, which is people connection, which is where you have to understand people and talk to people. That cannot be automated.
Right.
And if you do well, then you flourish in that.
Right. There's a common myth around this that HR students will have to start their careers with recruitment itself. Is that true, sir?
No, it is not true. I have not started my career with recruitment. I know a lot of friends of mine who have not started. And having said that, it is not true. I'll say that there is nothing wrong in it also. Mm-hmm. So starting, because HR as a function, 60% of your job, 70% of your job is recruitment.
Is hiring, right.
Right, is hiring. So if you are doing that in a consultant and you're doing it with an expert, then you're doing it with a specialized organization which is good at hiring. And in a span of 6 months, you have hired for technology company, you've hired from FMCG company, you've hired for manufacturing organizations. Every day is a new assignment to you.
Right.
So it isn't there. It's not bad. If it's an organized consultancy, if it's a organized recruitment work, then it is okay. Because recruitment is 70% bread and butter. And that is the only thing in HR which shows up in the dashboard. Kitne log khali the, kitna jaldi humne wo position bhar diye. So TAT of hiring, quality of hiring, these are the biggest things which comes into the business dashboard. That is the only HR thing which comes in dashboard. They will not ask how many rangolis have you made. They will only ask how many people you have recruited and how fast you have filled up the vacancies.
Right.
So recruitment is not a bad thing to do, and it's the most important thing to do.
Right. Another question here is, sir, how should a fresh talent keep a consistent balance in their performance while handling the expectations, stress and work pressure?
Just hold on one. Yeah, sorry. I need to get the question again.
Yeah, sure, sir. So the question is, how should a fresh talent keep a consistent balance in their performance while handling the expectations, stress, and work pressure?
So to me, it is very important that you have to balance the work and the pressure in a common way. If you love both,
mm-hmm.
then it balances each other, right? So you have a wife and a daughter at home. Do you have to balance between your wife and daughter? You don't, right? You don't try to balance. It automatically balances out. So if you love your personal life and your work life both together equally, it will balance out each other. You will not find that stress in between. So it is very important to love both the things, and then you will find a balance by yourself.
Right. Great. Great, sir. It was lovely interacting with you. But before we wrap on the session, we would like to take one career advice, though you have shared many. For all the students who are listening here right now, we have students with finance, HR, marketing, and IT specialization. As I told you, they're all in their final year now that they've stepped into their final year and would be looking for placements in coming 4 to 5 months to go. So one career advice which you would like to share with them.
One major career advice and one major question which you guys would be facing during this interview is that people will ask you that what have you done during pandemic and how have you created value during this time.
Right.
So have a very important example around that, number one. Second is that do not feel less confident that you have been through this pandemic, you have not been into classes, you have not done online, you have not done on-field inductions. Do not lose confidence because of that, because turn around this into a skill and show that you are adaptable and flexible. Mm-hmm. That you thought of doing a college-based activity, half of the year you did a college-based class and then you changed it to something else. Still your grades were not affected. Still your learning was not affected. So try and translate everything into a skill.
Right.
Try and translate all experiences of yours into a skill. That is the most important thing to do.
Great. Thank you so much, sir, for your valued time and sharing these experiences of yours, sharing the knowledge with our students. We actually look forward to having you in the campus very soon. Looking forward to a physical session as well with you where we can, interact with you in person. And it was indeed a wonderful experience having you, and we look forward to a continued association with you. To be presented. Can we please have the memento for sir? This is for you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. So we look forward to more such sessions with you in future as well.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you, Mr. Sharma. Thank you, Manchuti, for your help. Thank you very much. Thank you, all the students. Take care. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Please take care.